Hi everyone, and welcome to the HWBOT World Tour 2016 South Africa here in Cape Town. That would be awesome. That is the second event out of seven this year in five continents for one big championship. I've been joined with Peter Massman from HWBOT, director at HWBOT. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Perfect. This is all fine. This is the first time we came here to South Africa. That's going to be quite intense, as it's been for the past few days. If you guys have been watching the Facebook page of Overclocking TV, we have been posting some of the video we were recording in the car when we were actually stuck in the traffic. That was great. How are you doing, Mr. Peter?
I'm good. No troubles of jet lag or anything like that. People are very nice here. The workshop is going very well, so all good.
Perfect. So this is the second stop of the HWBOT World Tour 2016 edition. So let's present a little bit more the event itself. So what is the main goal of this event here?
So the main goal of every World Tour event is threefold. So we have a bench gathering where the extreme overclockers can come and join and enjoy, you know, their overclocking and share their passion. And then as second, we have the World Series. World Series is an extreme overclocking competition where the extreme overclockers sort of compete against each other with restrictions on hardware and restrictions on benchmarks. And the winner of the World Series competition wins a ticket to go to the World Championship at the end of the year in Berlin. And a third is the OC Workshop. So in the OC Workshop, we try and teach new people about overclocking. What is overclocking? How can you join overclocking? How can you join the community? How can you get started with competitions and so on? So how it works is for half an hour, we instruct people exactly this, how overclocking works. And then half an hour after that, they have a competition.
We're going to get a little bit more in detail into all that, but we are here at the Rage Expo. So that's the biggest South African exhibition about gaming, so from what I heard. This one is this. They have like two kind of expo here. They have one in Cape Town, so where we are today. They have like 500 gamers. Then they have one in Johannesburg, right? And it seems to have like a 1,000 gamers there in Johannesburg. So it's quite interesting to see all that. And we are here at this location. We are in the partner area, the
exhibitor
area. Yep. So there's actually a lot of people since early on this morning. The event's gonna last to the complete weekend. So we will have coverage for that. All weekend we have all the details for that. Guys, if you have any questions or want to react to what you are seeing today and being with us, you can use the hashtag HWT2016 on Twitter and Facebook if you want, and we'll be monitoring that with the questions as well. Thank you guys for joining on the live chat. Don't forget to subscribe to the follow button that should be actually on this side of the page on Twitch if you want to have more information about when we go live and what we are streaming live at this point. Mr. Peter.
Yes.
How do you catch up with the heat and the food heat so far?
With the heat and the food?
Yeah.
There's no problem whatsoever. This is very good food here. So, and it's not that warm either. So it was pretty cold when we left in Taipei. So.
So it's pretty much like home, right?
There's not that much difference. Good food, good temperature, no complaints.
Perfect. We have a transmitter Niven on the live chat, as well as David SP27 and Dark Gregor. So that's good to see you guys on the live chat. If you have any questions, don't hesitate. That's on the side of Massman. So Massman's should be watching the chat and reading the question if you ever have some. So the schedule for this weekend is actually quite basic. So we will have the schedule as follow. So today is the opening show. This is right now. The kickoff is now. Tonight, very important, we have at 7 p.m. local time, we have the OC show. That's going to be an OC show dedicated to the South African community of overclockers. We have Neo from the overclockers. We have Dr. Weez. We have Vivi, and we have Quantum X. And these guys represent actually the top overclocker here in South Africa. So that's going to be interesting to ask them some questions, especially to Dr. Weez and Vivi, how they plan to do it in the next few months and what they have in the pipe. In between, these are the highlights, but in between they can have we can go live at any moment to actually share with you something. So maybe one of the overclockers is benching with liquid nitrogen. It's fun to see. And that's something we will show you guys and we'll be commenting on it. And keep in mind that these time are the highlights. So tonight is the OC show. Tomorrow is the HWBOT World Series Extreme Qualifiers. And we'll have a short break in between by the time to rearrange some of the tables. And we'll have the HWBOT World Series Extreme Final tomorrow evening. So that's going to be tomorrow evening time in Europe as well. So we do expect a lot of you guys to tune in for this special show. And on Sunday morning, that's going to be the amateur final. Once again, that's going to be a one versus one, but we will be going a little bit more in detail for that in the next few minutes. Peter, let's get back to the workshop. So the workshop, as you say, that's something you want to teach for the newcomers, how you overclock. So how does it work exactly?
So it's a very basic introduction to overclocking. So we try to explain that we are people who enjoy getting the most out of any system, any hardware system. We are the extreme guys, so we use the liquid nitrogen, but we cover just the amateur part, the ambient cooling. You know, so we're using an all-in-one water cooling and a Skylake system to sort of introduce people to overclocking. We try to explain why we do it. You know, for us, it's a passion, but you can also do it to get more performance in your games or for your video rendering. And we also explain how you can do it. So we go into Intel Extreme Tuning Utility and explain, you know, if you increase the CPU ratio, your frequency will be multiplied by the base clock frequency, and then you get your final operating frequency, which results in a certain benchmark score. And if you increase the ratio, you get a higher score, so you get more performance.
So that's basically what you teach the guy for 30 minutes.
Yeah.
So what happened after that?
After the 30 minutes of introduction, we give them each a system to compete in. So everyone's competing with the same hardware, and it's their first overclocking competition. So at the end of the competition, we look at the four amateurs with the highest scores, and they get back for a final where they can win some cool prizes.
That's awesome. Actually, the prizes are quite big. Like the first one win almost a complete PC.
Yeah, a motherboard, a power supply, a CPU, a memory kit.
And the second one win pretty much everything the same without the memory kit, and the third one win the memory kit.
Yeah.
So that's actually quite intense for a first competition for someone that didn't know about overclocking before, and that is what the workshop is all about. There's actually a lot of people doing it already on the other side of this table where we do stream. What is the hardware we are using for the workshop?
So we're using a Core i7 6700K, an Intel Skylake processor. As a motherboard, we have a MSI Gaming Pro Carbon. So it's a Z170 motherboard. For the PC, we have a Seasonic Platinum 760 watt power supply. And then on the memory side, we have a G-Skill Trident Z 8GB kits with the rated speed is 3466. And then for as a water cooling, we have a Corsair all-in-one water cooling. I believe it's the H80i GT.
Last time we checked, that was the exact name of the...
With two fans on both sides of the radiator.
In push-pull, yeah. So that's quite a high-end system in a way. It's like, it's not the highest one you can get with like X99, but this is quite high-end for a beginner.
Yeah, we have to bear in mind that on Intel systems, we can only overclock with the more expensive CPUs. So we have a Core i5K processor and then a Core i7K processor. Ideally, we'd have a Skylake alternative like the Pentium K and Haswell.
That would be awesome. Intel, if you're watching this, that would be awesome.
Yeah, so we can. It's easier to relate to people that, hey, you can also overclock on a cheap system and then get a bit more performance. And the key point to remember is the moment that people get into the whole overclocking thing, they'll not go back to anything else. Once you've had the freedom of an unlocked CPU, you're not going to go back and, hey, now I'm going to lock everything. No, that does not happen.
Definitely. Yeah, a G3258 edition for Skylake will be quite awesome. Well, we have to wait 10 years for the new anniversary edition, I guess. Well, anyway, so that's a good system, and part of the system they can win by participating in this competition. So far, there's people actually lining up for that. So the workshop will be happening for today and tomorrow, right?
Yeah, that's correct.
So how many people do you expect to tune in for this workshop?
The workshop itself is with five people. So five people get the introduction and then five people move on after 30 minutes to the workshop system. We can do a workshop. So every about 40 minutes, we have a new stream of people coming in. Mm-hmm. And we do the workshop. We start at 12. Tomorrow we start at 11. And then we finish by 6 or 7 p.m. So you do the math.
Yeah, that's going to be quite intense. I guess that the planning will be quite packed as it was this morning. So we
fully booked.
Fully booked all this morning, so that is that's great to see. And this is the first day, so people just discovered this today. So they will maybe pass the word of mouth, telling your friends, "Hey, you should try to go see that. That's going to be awesome." For you guys actually watching the live all weekend, we might as well stream some of the tutorials and some Q&A. So if you have any question, you can always ask them on the live chat. It doesn't have to be exactly for the same system. Even if you have a system at home that you want to overclock and you don't know exactly what you could do or how you could do, this is basically an open mic stream we're going to be doing in between the highlights. So don't hesitate to ask us the questions on the live chat or using the hashtag HWT2016 on either Twitter or Facebook. Peter, so this was for the workshop part. Let's talk about the World Series. So we have the World Series for Extreme and World Series for Amateur. Let's talk to the Amateur because that's linked to the workshop so far.
So the Amateur World Series, it's basically the competition that we have for the Amateur Overclocker. So after the workshop, you move on to a qualification system. All of them have the same system and we only use the XTU benchmark. We use that in the workshop and we use that in the qualifier as well. So for 2 days, we run the workshop as well as the World Series for Amateurs. And then at the very end, we find the four amateurs who have the highest scores across those 2 days. And they can come back for a 1-versus-1 final.
The 1-versus-1 is going to be on Sunday morning. That's going to be streamed live right here with the commentary. So we will, even if you don't know, if you just tune in and you don't know what this is, you should actually tune in Sunday morning, no question asked, because we will explain everything as they are going through the different steps. And we did that in Brazil. That was like 2 months ago from now. We did that in Brazil 2 months ago, and it was actually extremely fun to do the commentary for and to see them actually overclocking. Mm-hmm. Because they are all in XTU, so they are all in the same system. It's super easy to explain what is going on for that. So they do qualify. They end up at the 1-versus-1 and they can win some hardware. That's awesome. So if you're at Rage here in South Africa, Cape Town, you should actually come to the HWBOT World Tour booth in the exhibition area and register yourself for the workshop and then try out your luck on this awesome new system that we have right here. That is looking good so far.
Yeah.
Love it.
There's going to be a lot of people contending for the final, so you'll have to pay attention in the workshop.
It's only 30 minutes. That's super easy. So this is for the amateur part. There's also the more extreme part. Let's start with the gathering itself. So the gathering is basically people come and have LN2.
Yep.
So what can they do during that time?
It's an open gathering. So you can do anything you want with overclocking. You can bring anything you want. You can run any benchmark you want. You can just make use of all the LN2 that we have.
So basically, some of the guys will be benching for some online competitions where they are here this weekend. And tomorrow, we will have the HWBOT World Series Championship. So the qualifier is the same. They can use anything they want.
Yeah, correct.
Even the benchmark?
The benchmarks, no. So in the qualifiers for the World Series, we have 5 benchmarks where the CPU is limited to 5 gigahertz. So we do have a restriction on you need to use a Z170 motherboard. And because it's a 5G limited clock frequency, the memory kit is the same for everyone as well.
Okay, and so they're going to have to use this and then they can move, they get qualified for that. So how the qualifier works, how many of them will get qualified for the final?
So the top 4 will qualify for the final.
Okay, and the final will be 1-versus-1 as well.
Yep, correct.
So how do you choose the first one go against the third one, the second one go against the fourth one? How does it work?
So it's 1-versus-4 and then 2 against number 3 in the semifinals, and then it's 1-versus-1, 30 minutes with one benchmark selected by lucky draw. Basically, it's picking a benchmark from a hat, and then you have 30 minutes to max out your system as high as possible.
That's quite interesting because they won't know the benchmark
It's a different system like the MOAs before, where MOAs and GOCs and the HOTs and the AOCs and all the traditional overclocking competitions where you'd have 6 hours the time to max out 2 benchmarks. And You know, let's be honest, the skill of these extreme overclockers is incredibly high, much higher than 5 years ago. And they can max out a system in 2 hours' time. That's not a problem. So in order to challenge the extreme overclockers a bit more, we need to impose a time limitation where now the time becomes, you know, one of the toughest parts of the challenge.
So timing is the key.
Yes, and you need to be able to troubleshoot very quickly. You need to know exactly what your hardware is capable of. You need to find out, okay, if I have this postcode issue, what does it mean and how can I fix it?
So you have to come prepared.
Yeah, of course.
But there's some of the hardware that you haven't tested before.
You need to come prepared both in terms of the hardware as well as your methodology.
That's going to be interesting to see that. So out of the 6 benchmark, which one do we have?
Out of the 6 benchmarks?
Yeah, the 6 benchmark, what are they?
Oh, so it should be W Prime, GPU Pi, Cinebench, SuperPi, XTU, and I think Reference Clock.
It's actually funny that you remember all of them, because usually you never manage to tell all that.
It's my job to remember.
So that's it. 2 semi-finals, then 1 final, 1 versus 1. The winner of this final get a plane ticket, actually a transportation to the World Championship final to happen in Berlin, Germany.
Yeah, that's correct.
That's going to be by the end of the year. Is the date announced yet?
Not announced yet. It will be in December, and we're hiding out at the Case King Gaming booth.
Right. That's going to be fun to be at the best location we could have for this kind of event.
Yeah.
That would be fun to see. So this is great for the Azure Blue World Series, but this kind of event will... it's very important that it's going along the year. Talking a little bit more about the final to happen in December, you guys at HWBot did announce the structure by itself a little bit earlier. So can you describe a little bit what is the exact structure of the complete World Championship?
Yeah, so as I mentioned already before, at every of the World Tour stops, we have a World Series event. And the winner of every World Series competition gets a ticket and accommodation paid to the World Overclocking Championship at the end of the year. At the championship, the 8 overclockers, so we have 6 events, so 6 winners, plus 2 tickets, which we still have to determine, we know how to give them away, but we have to still announce how to get to give them away. So 8 people will qualify for the World Championship.
No leaks.
8 people qualify for the World Championship at the end of the year. They're divided into 2 groups of 4. The 2 groups of 4, they all do 1 versus 1 matches against each other. And then the winner gets 3 points, and the winner just gets 3 points. There is no tie in this game. So, of those 2 groups, we determine who's ranked number 1 to number 4. And then the winner of Group A will compete against 4th place of Group B in the quarterfinal. And then the quarterfinals, we go down to the semifinals, we go to the final, and eventually we learn who is the overclocking world champion of 2016.
That's going to be quite intense, because this event, like this championship, is going on the whole year. Mm-hmm. Like 7 different locations, 7 different live events. That is actually one of the biggest ones for the past few years.
I think so, yeah.
I think the last kind of event of that scale was back in 2010, with the MOA and GOOC of that world.
Yeah, that's quite possible, yeah.
That's quite impressive to have a... to have these to be out on the main stage, I would say.
So another part of the World Championship, a very important part, is sort of the how do we structure the brands and the hardware and that kind of stuff. So we have partners at every of the World Tour events who provide the hardware and who provide us basically also with the financial support to get these events. This is not very cheap to run. This is quite an endeavor. So the partners, they supply the hardware for the workshop as well as for the World Series. And then the winner of the World Series has to compete with the brands that he qualified on in the World Tour. So at the Rage here, we have partnership with Intel, with MSI, with Seasonic as main partners. So the winner of the World Series here in Rage will be competing on an MSI motherboard with an Intel CPU and a Seasonic power supply.
And G-Skill memory.
And G-Skill memory in at the end of the year in the World Championship.
So that's interesting to see that for this event, there's going to be these four limitation or restriction, I would say, or requirement. Let's call it requirement. But if you look at Paolo Pesce-Agassi from Brazil that won the HW World Series in Brazil 2 months ago, it will be using something else. So that would be interesting to see this kind of high-level competition with different kind of hardware from different people.
Yeah, so in Brazil, we had we worked together with Gigabyte and HyperX primarily, and also Seasonic. So he'll be using HyperX memory, HyperX SSDs, Gigabyte motherboard. So yeah, it's going to be interesting to see, you know, how they will be able to. You know, you have to practice with these brand with these products as well. So yeah, looking forward to it.
That's going to be interesting. And do you know already the final, how it's going to look? That's going to be one versus one as well.
Well, so as I mentioned, you have to pay attention. I explained this before. You know, it's two groups, then quarterfinal, semifinal, final, and then celebrations.
But you were just talking about groups. Are they like four against four or two against two in terms of?
Oh no, it's one versus one inside the groups.
One versus one for everyone.
I think maybe we have to simplify this a bit more for the, you know, simple spirits among us.
Like me. Well, thank you, Peter, for all the details for the World Championship. Let's go back to this event, the HWBOT World Tour here in South Africa at Rage in Cape Town. So as we say, as we told you earlier, Rage is actually the biggest gaming exhibition in South Africa. They have one in Johannesburg, they have one here in Cape Town. And it's quite impressive to see like all these people coming here from all age. There's a lot of girls as well.
Yep.
It's quite diverse in terms of... Of viewership and people attending. As you say, this kind of championship and world tour is quite costly to run, and this will not be able to be as successful as it is without the partners. So of let's course, go back yeah. To present all the different partners that we have. Let's start with Seasonic, because that's the HWBOT World Tour season partner. Mm-hmm, so yeah. What is it exactly, the season partner?
So Seasonic decided at the very end, the very beginning of the year, when we were, you know, showing what we were planning for the entire year, decided this is an amazing, amazing initiative. So we'll back you up for the entire world tour. So every tour stop, they provide us with the power supplies for the event. So we get a Seasonic Platinum 760 watt for both the OC Workshop as well as the World Series.
Nice. That's super great. Thank you, guys. So for you guys that doesn't know who is Seasonic, they're actually a manufacturer of power supply mainly. So they do own some of the manufacturing, or very close to the manufacturing. And this is they have different PSU as well. One of the one we're using it is the Seasonic 760 watt Platinum series, yep. If I'm right. And they also have a version that is in white, the white edition. Yeah. So they have a. They have both in black and in white series for the PSU. If you have a PC modding that is full white and black, that's perfect for it. Second partner is NAG. Who is NAG, actually?
So NAG is the online gaming community. They used to have a physical magazine as well. Everything is online now. And it's one of the largest gaming websites in South Africa. They are also the organizers of Rage here in Cape Town. First Rage in Cape Town, as well as the Rage that was that's been going on in Johannesburg for many, many, many years.
So, but actually, like, is that the Rage or the Rage?
I think it's Rage.
Rage.
So they are here. They're the part of the partner that make this HWBOT World Tour things that happen. Next one is MSI.
MSI, yeah.
So who is MSI?
MSI is a long-term partner of HWBOT. They joined HWBOT in 2009 already. So we've been working with them together for a very long time. They've recently been going through a sort of a rebranding. So they've rebranded their company as a gaming company, and they've been doing fantastic in terms of gaming. Like they're everywhere. And for this event, they join up on the motherboard side. So they provide us with the Z170A Gaming Pro Carbon motherboard.
Yeah. That's as they're a partner of the event, the guys will be using this brand in the final for the Extreme as well.
Yep. So both the amateurs getting used to MSI and how MSI motherboards respond to overclocking very well, and the Extreme guys are using it in the finals as well to qualify for the World Championship.
So that's going to be an all MSI sponsored final, same as Seasonic, same as Intel, well, same as Jiskill. for this event, I mean.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Not in the World Championship. It's possible, but...
So the next one is Intel. So of course we all know Intel, manufacturer of the so far the most powerful CPU you can get on the market.
Yeah.
And one of the most loved CPU by the overclockers, I would say.
It's their case CPUs are very very popular on HWBot.
Well, that's although is the thing that's only the case you can be overclocked officially. So.
Also the XQs, but that's on X99 platforms. That's a bit more expensive. So for the mainstream platform, the ones that we're using here, Skylake, there's the Core i7-6700K and then the Core i5-6600K. Both are fully unlocked, so you can change the multiplier to anything you want. You can change the memory divider to anything you want. And you can increase the frequency to however high you want.
Until you get the RMA. But so far, it's actually, like talking about the RMA, we had some questions on the live chat. How many of these systems get burned by the amateurs? And we have to admit, zero in 2 years of world tour. None, let's say none of the system ever burned. And we put them in hand of people that had no clue whatsoever about overclocking before. And I remember, I will remember that one like for a long time. That was in Europe last year. And one of the pro, like extreme overclocker was coming and says, I will never try that high of the voltage on the air cooling system. And nothing happened. They would just get the security kicking on and just the PC shut down and everything, but they will never burn the system. So if you guys are watching this and you never try overclocking before, as long as you don't deactivate all the safety features, it will be all right. So I think it's like more than 280 people tried to play with this system and none of them managed to burn anything. So this is super safe in a way.
Someone is mentioning that we're using them on the Pentiums and a good cooler. So the Pentium Anniversary doesn't use the Haswell architecture, but only two cores and no hyperthreading. So a really gimped CPU. In Brazil, we use these CPUs for the workshop as well. In Brazil, the temperature was 34 degrees inside with humidity about 70%. And we used the Intel stock coolers. And still, they were pushing 1.5 volts through the CPUs running at 4.5, 4.6 gigahertz. None of the CPUs died through the entire event.
But even us, we were actually surprised on how high they can reach with it.
Yeah, and it was no problem whatsoever. We did not have any hardware issues. It's difficult. It's difficult to get these CPUs dead. Even if you try.
Don't try it at home. So that was for the main partners. Let's switch to the other one. So Jiskill is also one of the partners. So they're supplying the memory, right?
Yeah. So they're providing a kit of 2x4 GB Trident Z memory. Their Trident Z is the ones with the really nice heatsinks. I really like design. I can't help it. It's just very well designed. So the kit is 3466. I think it's C15 or C16. Our contact in Jiskill promised that they were very good overclockers, and one of the extreme guys tried them yesterday night already, and he said indeed that they're pretty good overclockers.
That's going to be the same kit that we'll be using for the final of the extreme.
Correct. Yes.
So indeed, that's going to be interesting to see. Tomorrow evening, so Saturday evening, tune in for the HWBot World Series Final Extreme. I will be using that, and if you want to see more, you can tune in on Sunday morning for the HWBot World Series Amateur Final, where they will be using the same memory kit in there. Second partner is Computex Tetra. Can you present a little bit who is this partner and why they are actually here?
So Tetra is the organization that... that takes care of the, you know, getting Computex up and running every year in Taipei, early June time. So Computex is one of the largest IT trade shows. I believe that it's currently the place to be every year if you want to learn more about components and stuff, motherboards and graphics cards and stuff like that. And we've teamed up with Tetra to also bring the world tour to Computex in June. So we'll be at Computex doing this exactly the same stuff in Taiwan. At Computex.
All right, that's gonna be quite intense, I guess.
More details to be announced soon, but they also wanted to join us for the entire world tour around the world.
That's great to have them in this in in this location as well with us. Next one is The Overclocker. So this is the special full-on overclocking magazine.
The best overclocking magazine, period.
I can't disagree with that. So the schedule is about like every month or every 2 months, depending on the time of the year. There's always good stuff in like articles, reviews. There's also some of the interviews with some of the overclockers. So that's why it's called The Overclocker in in a way. Makes sense, huh? Next partners, media partner is overclock.net.
One of the largest overclocking forums in the world. They've joined us last year for the North American event as well, and this year they want to join us for the entire world tour. So they help us out with sharing the noise about the world tour, getting people sort of excited about it, and especially their forum has a lot of enthusiasts, amateur enthusiasts as well. So you know, I think for those people, this is an interesting occasion to learn more about overclocking and.
Well, that's fun. Next, let's switch directly to the next media partner, that is Techmundo.
Techmundo is, I think, Brazil's largest IT media. So they joined us for the Brazil World Tour with some interesting talks online on the live stream. I think you can still watch those on YouTube.
Yeah, all the replay for the live we did in the AWBOT World Tour 2016 in Brazil are available on Overclocking TV YouTube page. So you just go to YouTube and look for Overclocking TV in one word, and you're gonna find them right there. We have a playlist especially just for that. And that was actually fun to have the live with Fabio from Techmundo. That was one of the editors there. We did co-host for the first time. We did the co-host and commentary of a competition that was in both language, English and Portuguese. That was quite interesting to do as well. So here we'll be doing it in English with a French accent and English regular one. Next partner is Corsair.
Corsair. So they provide all-in-one water cooler. Corsair is very well known for their memory, their SSDs, their all-in-one coolers. And very recently, they've also, you know, they've joined the gaming. The gaming trend?
Hype.
So they make the keyboards with their fancy RGB. They have mice, headsets, everything. You know, go check out their website to learn more. I'm not a Corsair salesperson. So they joined here at the World Tour with the all-in-one. So they provide the cooling for the Skylake processors. They brought the H80i GT. With them, which is fine for Skylake overclocking. I think that the CPUs are running at about 40 to 50 degrees centigrade, which is great because the ambient temperature is about, I think, 25 to 30 degrees here. So
yeah, it's still quite hot. I still feel quite hot here.
Yeah. That's because you're sitting next to me.
Okay. Thank you, Peter. next partner, Streecom. So that one is completely new to a lot of people. So let's first explain who they are, and then we're going to explain why they are here.
So Streecom is a high-end case manufacturer who does design cases, and they've joined the World Tour because we are sort of together with the Overclocking TV and Streecom and HWB, we've designed this bench table for overclockers.
What? This is new.
Yeah, and it's a design table. It's designed to be compact and easily portable. So you know that a lot of the other, a lot of bench tables currently, they're pretty big. You know, you can mount all sorts of things on it. This one is designed to be, you know, you can put it in your backpack and travel with it.
That's actually how we bring one here.
Yeah, true.
So guys, this is completely new. This bench table does not exist anywhere else. There is only two prototypes in the world that are made. There is one here, and if you want more information, you can ask us on the live chat on Twitch or on Twitter using the hashtag #HWT2016. If you want more information, more picture and everything, there is one right next to this table that is actually being used for the teaching system in here. I could have this one on the live. But keep in mind, next weekend we will be in Europe for HWBOT World Tour 2016 Europe at the Gamers Assembly. We will have an official Q&A, for 1 hour on how this project came through, how is the state of the prototype, what are we thinking about doing with it. Like, every question will get answered next week. So you can ask this weekend. We will answer some of the questions. We will leak some more pictures, of course. But most importantly, if you want to have all the information about that, next weekend gonna be the biggest and ever Q&A about that, and we will release all the information about this benchtable, like when we can get it, where, how, why we do it, how we did it. So this is quite interesting to have them. So they will.
So people are already asking for some pictures, and I think we leaked a couple on our Facebooks.
Actually, but if you look on Facebook.com, you should actually be able to find a page with that. So let me make sure the page does exist. And if you, yeah, I will post the. Oh yeah, if you look for open, okay, I will pass the link on the live chat. Or actually, you can go to this. I cannot show you guys because I have like all the system pictures, and this is some of the picture that we did leaked in before. So these are actually this one and this one are the only two picture of this benchtable available right now on the internet. So guys, if you want more information, you can always ask on the live chat, but keep in mind, everything will be released by next week. So if you want to have the exclusivity of the information, tune in all this weekend and we'll be leaking more information soon. I have to admit, I'm super excited about this project. I love it. It's been super great to work on this project. So it's a joint project between Overclocking TV, HWBot, and Streecom. And it's definitely targeted to overclockers, but that will be more usage for that. More this weekend. And finally, the last partner is Overclocking TV. So basically, this is...
Never heard of these guys.
This is all what you're watching right here, right now. So yeah, we're going to be doing the live stream all weekend. And don't forget, you can always tune in. We will be having some highlights, but we will be streaming most of the time this weekend. We will be having some of the cameras on the Extreme Overclockers, some of the camera on the workshop as well. So if you want to know more about everything we did discuss in this opening show, you can always follow us here down there on Twitch, and that would be fun to have you around. So if you follow, you can activate the notification by email, so we'll receive an email every time we go live. And don't forget, tonight is the OC show.
Also check out the after movies on their YouTube channel.
There's the after movie about the campus party event. Ooh. So the world tour from 2 months ago, that was quite interesting. As well, if you have any question, you can always ask using the hashtag HWT2016. Peter, this is all for Rage, but I want to give a little teaser for next weekend. Because this weekend we're in South Africa. Next weekend we fly to Europe for the same event, but the European stop of the World Tour.
Exactly, yes.
But this World Tour in Europe has something a little bit special. It's called, like, the World Series have a special name.
So we're already working with MSI here at Rage, but we'll be working with MSI a bit more closer at Gamers Assembly. So at Gamers Assembly, the World Series competition is in fact the MSI MOA 2016 Europe, and the workshop is called the MSI OC Academy.
So that means we have a new competition, the MSI MOA, that is going back live.
Yes, exactly.
So last year it was online. That was the first year it was only made online, and this year is back live with live qualifier. That's going to be the HWBot World Series. That is basically now the MOA for the Europe stuff.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's going to be quite interesting. And if you want to see this one, you can always follow to there, or follow us on Facebook. You're going to get all the information.
I think that the European event is the second largest this year after the one that we do at Computex. We have a space both in the exhibitor area for the workshop and then to do the finals of both competitions. We also have a space for the gathering in sort of the more LAN area, which is getting close to sold out. I think if you want to join, you need to get your ticket very quickly.
Ticket and accommodation quite fast.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, thank you, Peter. This actually sum up a little bit the kickoff we had for this South African Rage event. Guys, stay tuned in here because we will be taking a short break, and then we will have some of the cameras on either what is going on at the booth here or what the Extreme Overclockers are doing right next to us. This was nice. You can watch this replay on YouTube. If you like this event and this kind of video, give it a thumbs up. If you don't like my face or this guy's face, give it a thumbs down. It will maybe hunt you, find you, and maybe kill you in your sleep. Wasn't that the Taken eyeline? I will find you even in your sleep and I will kill you. You don't free my daughter.
I don't know.
No, didn't watch that movie? Oh, okay. No. Too bad. Well, and if you don't like the joke, you can give it a thumbs down as well. And you can find everything back on YouTube, youtube.com/overclockingTV. And you can have all the information about what we are doing here on Facebook, either on HWBot page or OverclockingTV page. Guys, until the next time, don't forget, 7 p.m. tonight, local time, we have the OC show. So that's going to be 6 p.m. It's going to be about 6 p.m., I think, in Paris time. So tonight, 7 p.m., be there. Until then, keep pushing it.